Well, Italy is so well. So, I mean, I miss Italy so much. It's been like 3 years, no anymore over there. And I miss my sister. I miss some friend in my city, Molfetta, Bari. And I will be very glad to be back to Italy in a short period. But now focus on SAFF Championship and focus first on a friendly game versus Philippines. Nepal, Philippines, and then we'll be focused on SAFF Championship in India.
You know, Coach, from the time I started watching football, I remember 1998 World Cup was my first footballing experience. So at that time, my senior brothers used to tell me that Italy at one point was the country that had the best defense. For even later years, Italy is still, I think, it's still known for having that good defense. Maldini, Totti, those players. My God.
Cannavaro,
the only defender to win a Ballon d'Or.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
Yeah. We have this, specific position that can be central back, right back, left back, where also Baresi, eventually the position of libero, I mean, last man before. Yeah, we have this characteristic of the play of Italy that they are so great. And special before, they was so focused on this. This is start about our culture, not that many years back was defend play first. If you defend well, you can attack well also. And also theoretically and tactically about the counter-attack, the catenaccio, no? Maybe you make one action, but well coordinated, you can score one team. Then you cannot have a possession ball. You can stay without possession and then you can achieve the best point with only defend and try to, negotiations to score one goal. But right now in the last 2-3 years and even the last 10 years, we can see that after World Cup, something changed. Many influence of Spanish football or South America or Central America, South American football, where you can see more freedom movement, zone position of attacking phase. So like football, it's unbelievable change. And years by years, you need to study pressing, high pressing, set position where it can be about 20-30% of each goal scoring during 90 minutes. And so you need to be aware about that football is not only defense, but it's also attack, counter-attack, focus on the two phase, no? Attacking phase and defensive phase. Plus, there is many, many advice that you can share with specific players, specific system, 4-3-3, 3-5-2, 4-4-2, 4-2-3-1. I mean, many system that now influence the football, many school influence the football. And
But there are many tactics that has evolved now. Like before, there was this 4-4-2 which stayed for a very long time. It's still there. And I remember one of the Nepali coaches, Raju Kaji Shakya, telling me one time, and it really hit me, that he told me that Avash, our Nepali football, the best formation for this, not the national team, but the club football, is 4-4-2. And I couldn't agree more. Because I think the Nepalese players currently, we lack the technicalities of the modern day football, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah, a bit. You're right. It's not about criticize the Nepali coach. Is about to criticize a bit the system, how the delivery, the B license, the A license. Here in Nepal, still not doing the pro license, but around the country of Asia, they already start to do it. I think, mini of delivery license. I mean, who give the license here in Asia, especially? They are focused on other subject that they don't really teach the tactically, individual tactically, team tactically. And I think we are in Europe a bit a step forward on this. I will love to have more here in Nepal, more foreigner coach that can make a good impact for Nepali A division team, and good impact also for the future of national team. We can see that in India, I can explain myself that I was working 3 years already over there. They have academy coach that they are foreigner, and we miss about academy coach that can be foreigner or local. So I will love to see in Nepal more foreigner coach, more foreigner technical advisor for the club. Can be technical director or goalkeeper coach or physical coach. We don't have a physical coach in Nepal, and a physical coach or match analysis coach is one figure that a professional football player as a Nepali national team we need to develop in Italy, in Nepal.
Also, I think what I feel is the way I see international football, yes, it has gone miles away from us, but there are some steps that we can take, like the importance of a stats guy, of a stats man that gets the stats, brings it down. Okay, you don't need to have a GPS put into the players and crunch all the data. Just analyze the game, the long range shot they're taking. If you noticed in the league, a lot of players take long range shots, but maybe out of 50, there are 2 to 3 being converted right now. So now as a player, you should know that if I am shooting 2 or 3 long range shots per game, I'm missing all of them, then I should either go back to my basics and go practice and come back, or I should stop doing that because my accuracy is decreasing. So there's nobody to tell them that your accuracy is low during when you apply a long range shot. So these kind of things are, I think, important, and the importance of a stats person, an analyst, lacks in Nepali football, domestic and the national team.
Yeah, for sure. If I know well, they will say to me that before was Istat in a division club, so it was so great. Because Istat, we scout, example. There was one good program for analyze all this data that you spoke about. And as I say before, we need more coach analyzing that they are ready to cut the special movement of attacking phase, defensive phase, or some set position. This is can make Nepal football a bit more high. As I say to you, in India, they're a bit in advance on this because almost all ISL and I-League team have maybe 2 match analysis, no one. Individual match analysis and team match analysis. And this creates a very big difference. So you can study individual mistake, as you say, and you can properly make a training for individual the improvement of a football game.
Definitely. So, I want to jump back to time once again. So, let's start from the very first. Your father was also a footballer.
Yeah. My father is. It was a football player, as a central back, but I was a different quality. You know, it's. It was a more like aggression to play to the first ball as an older stopper of central back of Italy. And me have more, if I can compare myself, I have more quality with the ball and more tactical addition playing in the middle. So for my continuous injury. I leave the football at age 22, 23.
I want to ask you one thing here. So while I was doing my research, I found out it was injury that bothered you to play. So it was it one serious injury or was it like serious of few injuries?
No, well, I can explain. I was all the time reach, and I want to reach all the time the top of what I doing. And I was in Venice in the top level and doing all the time like get many injury and don't provide even to training. It's making so frustrating. And plus I have like in many years I've loved to coach in even young age. So they make fast make decision to leave the professional football and to start to coaching. One way to coach in Italy was also to be a teacher, because be teacher also helped me to be a coach. So I was started to school, secondary school, university school, and nothing. But of course, I, at age 38 that I am, I still very well remember when I was a player, and I miss this. I think it's each person in the football background, they have some like limit. And one of my limits is to get all the time injury. And so I'm happy now, and I enjoy to be coach of a Nepal national team.
Wonderful. Come to that. But before that, I want to ask, so how many years have you been as a coach? Can we? It's more than 10 years.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, at age 27, 28, okay. I go abroad. Mm-hmm. But before I was like a physical coach and assistant coach in Tours Division. I do this passion and I work in many countries. I can say some, no, China, Latvia, Estonia, Armenia, Indonesia, Kosovo, Palestine, Ghana, Belize.
Wow.
So India. And,
it's pretty right interesting now, Nepal. List.
Yes. So like, I work in many countries and almost I feel comfortable in many countries. I enjoy football in many countries. It's been, I think, four different continents, right, to work. And India was in the last 3 years. Now it's okay, it's done. we hope to make a good successful also. And we start to do also good successful with Nepal, with the Nepal national team.
And now let's go to India, because the names you shared, that's a very impressive CV. To say it very professionally. So the experiences you have taken from country to country, you've already been there in like three continents,
yeah.
Right? So Indian football really fascinates me, because we were somewhere similar to them a few years ago, maybe a decade ago or two. But the way they're trying, they're making the stride towards the World Cup, they're aiming for the World Cup, I think the next World Cup. So the vision they carry, that could be, and that is the what the vision reflects on the league itself. So Gokulam, back-to-back champions under coach Vincenzo Alberto Annese. Is that the right pronunciation?
Yeah, sure. Annese, but Annese. It's fine. It's totally fine. You... Really, my pleasure that you say the right word, the right
thank
name.
God.
Many of journalists, they mistake, but you done well. Well, in India, it was when I come to India, this club that was offering, he never have a win champion of league. And there was a ask me to reach the playoff stage. And we start with all academy players and some, of course, foreigner, because there was a 3+1, 3 foreigner plus 1 Asian foreigner, quota. So we make a team from zero, and my first staff, my first starting was very bad. Like each country when I start, only Nepal I think I done so well, because it was a small tournament and we won the tournament. But in India, at the same pole, it was one tournament, local tournament in Kolkata, and I remember we lost this tournament, and I received a lot of pressure on myself. Oh, why this coach? You know, because one foreigner coach must all the time win. But I think the fourth game I lost, and then after the third and fourth, then I start to make. I make also record to India. I think still I am there, because I'm the only coach that with 21 consecutive positive result.
Wow!
And I have, as you say, I have win two-time I League champion. Before
back to back,
back to back, one foreigner coach I have never done before. So, big plus going to my player and to all, to my physical coach that was foreigner, my match analysis that right now he signed with East Bengal. I know he's Aromal. I was also like a kind of lucky to be part of this. We make history in India. Then the third years, I decided to don't continue with Gokulam, because I want more. I would love to be in ISL, I will tell the truth. And I make a couple of interview in the beginning. I know start with ISL, but club of Northeast United is was calling me for the project of 2 years. And I start to coach Northeast United, and it was amazing experience. Not so much successful, but we have done so many improvement in the short time. I think in 3 months I have done only 21 training. And because you need to fly then back, but we improved so much. It's one team that he was scoring only 4 goal in the first 8 game. We start to score a lot of goal, so and we start to win, to draw. We make huge impact also in ISL. So I decide to stop the contract with Northeast United in India, in ISL, to be in Nepali football. I can say my choices was only for think about my CV, to improve my CV. Being a national team coach in Asia is always a plus one for one coach. Young like me also, I'm 38. So I think about, I make this decision only for the CV.
And it's also, it's always a challenge. It's good to have new challenges in life. So I wanted to know, how's the fan culture of I-League and ISL? How do you find that?
Gap different. But almost, I mean...
Which one is better?
In ISL, there is more interesting. There is more...
entertainment.
Entertainment. There is more broadcast. Glamour. Broadcast, glamour. More big stadium, and in ISL there is for sure more supporters, but also I-League in Kerala, there are in Gokulam, there are crazy about Gokulam, so and there is a huge respect right now in Gokulam, a huge expectation to be in ISL League. I think also club like Gokulam right now, after two-time champion, I think deserve to be in ISL, and maybe some club for Gokulam maybe is better than some ISL club. Better like a professionalism, like a player, like utens of the players, because the player they come from Kerala, even Kerala Premier League is so good. I mean, I believe that maybe some club of Kerala Premier League, they can be even in ISL. I mean, there is many, many club strong in Kerala. And as I say, Gokulam as an organization, as a president, as a supporter, they deserve to be in ISL.
So we can say that the footballing culture in India is currently now better than Nepal, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, better than Nepal because there are more people, there are more investment in football. There are more foreigner coach. There are more foreigner as a player. Yes. There are so much gap different between money also. I mean, we can see like we lost, I think, 47 player right now. Yeah. Of they go to Australia. That's why, because there is no so much investment in football.
Maybe there was also a long gap between the A division last year and this year. Almost it started after a year's gap.
Yeah. And I can understand also the football player. Here, the football player may be the best that they play national team. They get the maximum $2,000, $3,000 when it will be good. When maybe in some player of ISL, they can get even, I can say, $200,000 for one year. I mean, I talk about a national team player, plus a sponsor, plus every plus they can get from football federation, from sponsor, from many other, from club, from owners, from bonus. I mean, there is a huge difference. I think we cannot at all comparing the two league, even I league, or even I can say sometimes even Kerala Premier League, they can be more huge than Nepal A division. It doesn't matter to create some difference between one club or one country, between another country. I know and I support very well Nepal people. I love them. They are so kind. And the main rival there are India. No, we know everybody when we play versus India.
Rival, yes.
And so I don't want to say this, but I say the truth about investment, about all, also about organization. No, because they can play like week by week, game by game. So you have time to prepare physical, prepare. Yeah, foreigner coach also in Kerala Premier League. So in the state of Kerala. So we need to be aware about this, but this doesn't matter that can be a minus or plus for a national team player.
So like every time we say the importance of a foreign coach, I think that's what we're mentioning about the exposure that the foreign coach brings to that country, especially countries from the from South Asia, we would be very, we would gain a lot of knowledge if we got a coach from especially Europe, right? If because the football development there in Europe is totally different. It's a total ball game there. So I think even in the past, we had a coach from England. So he was Tottenham's defender, Graham Roberts, and he was called the hard nail. And he did some good performance. The team delivered in the, it was 2013 SAFF Championship. In the semi-final, we missed a penalty and we got out of the tournament. But it was, all in all, as a fan, that was a good tournament for me. And I could see some changes as well. So, also recently, our coach, Abdullah Al-Mutayri, for me, he had some issues outside the ground, but the game he showed, I think the best thing he instilled in this lot, or the lot that was there, was the game is always won and lost in the midfield. So Nepali team, maybe in my time, I saw for the very first time, holding, commanding in the midfield.
Well, football is so fast, so we don't need to comparing what was before and what is now. Because it don't make any plus or minus. In Nepal, they love too much this comparison between one coach and another coach. Mm. I know that Almuntari, they have a very big fans here, and I'm so happy for the fans of Almuntari. I will always respect this. I can say, you know, for Nepalese supporter, I mean, I am one coach that win five different trophies in five different countries. Mm. And I will give all myself for reach the best point of Nepali football. I don't care what they think the supporter about, maybe previous ANFA statement of who was boss before, who was president before, who was president now. I just think about myself, about my CV, and to reach the good level of football. For coming back to your question, I invite personally the 14 I division coach personally of Nepal League, and they come only four.
You invited all of them?
Yeah. Okay. So sometime, the people need to be motivated to learn some thinking from somebody. And I will love to see more foreigners, because maybe they can change the mentality to be more unique, to be no jealous about the other coach, to be no thinking about the superiority, and to think only to be nearby themselves, nearby the Nepali football players, nearby Nepal developing football. Here in Nepal, many times they think if you win the SAFF, you are the best, you are the king of champion. But you can develop in the football also in different way. Example, I try to push forward this all my Nepali player, national team player, to try to give a chance to play abroad. And they need this chance. Sabrita is the striker of Nepal female. I try to give her one opportunity abroad, and maybe in the few weeks we can know where it can be, and maybe they can play in Europe.
I was about to ask that. Are we talking about Europe?
I mean, he's one of the top striker in India. He has a speed, top striker, 1 or 2, 3 years now with the club in India, and I believe she can play 100% in Europe. So I would love to see some Nepali player play abroad. Right now we have only Roy Chan, that many years is in Indonesia and make name of Nepali strong. And we have also Kiran, that our captain, that represent a club where win I league two time. I mean, we need to be grateful about these two players that in the last 7-8 years they only represent them abroad. Also some other player try to be abroad, but these guys, they are constantly abroad and they are constantly winner. I mean, player like these two in another country, they will make like a hero, but here they don't consider so much them. And I would love to take focus on these two player, because, and I would love to make other player like Ananta, like Anjan Bista, like Tangi, I mean Ayuk, Galan. I mean, there is a lot of talent in Nepal, and I would love to push for them to go outside the Nepali country.
The names just you just mentioned, Ananta and Anjan, and especially also Bimal Ghartimagar, Bimal. So they were once sent for trial in Europe. They went across Europe for trials and everything. And according to some rumors, I heard the officials wanted some money out of Bimal. So it is a very unofficial news that came to my ears. Let's say grapevine, which might be true as well. So, just like, I think this is the factor that you mentioned these names that you've seen potential in them. Because once you see their ball touch is different, their playing style is different.
Yeah.
The way Anjan Bista cuts in, that's his trademark.
Yeah.
The way Bimal touches the ball and dribbles it past players, and the distance between his dribbling, the touch, the poise of touch Bimal has, that's different. And the command on Ananta Tamang has in the defense is different from the others, right, coach? So that makes the difference about a player.
Yes, for sure. I mean, this player that you nominate, I mean, there are they have a different quality, but also other player, like we can see that Avas from APF, that he have a
Avash Ghimire.
Yeah, that he play in Spain, that he was there in Spain for work, but he can't.
Bright prospect for Nepali football.
Very, very good. And there is a lot of young guys. I mean, even Kavas, for that he get the injury right now, but it was amazing. He was doing so well, central back, left back, right back. He's so fast, so powerful. We lost this player in this league. I'm so sad for this. But there are a lot. Also, Eric Bista.
Eric.
From is one midfielder with left foot quality. There is a lot of talent. In Nepal, guys, I don't know why, but they have a lot of talent. I mean, individually, we don't have academy. So that's why I say I don't know why. In general, academy team, when you start from under 10 and 11 and under 12, we need to build up this quality. But in Nepal, there is no this academy. So all this poor natural talent.
Mm.
And I can see in Nepal, there is a big talent. In each team, we can face not only the player that you nominated. We need maybe some great agent.
Mm.
To give this opportunity for them, no? I can see many times why I nominated Kieran and Royt, because I know how they considered Nepal abroad.
Mm.
All the time to be under discrimination when you go outside to think, oh, okay, this player come from Nepal, we are Indian, example. We are Indonesia, no? Better background of football. But believe me, this player, they fighting also like internal by psychology, and I hope also other players they can get this opportunity to play abroad. And I believe with a great agent, with a good advisor for them, they can reach this point.
Especially, we talked about, just now you mentioned the name Rohit Chand. So I feel like Rohit is one that versatile player who can play from any position.
Sure, sure.
You he's put him fast. In the forward, he's going to score a goal.
Yeah, he's fast, he's strong. He can use also left foot, right foot. I mean, he have a personality, he have experience. I mean, I remember when I was with PSCS Semarang, I was facing... Persija Jakarta, he was playing Persija, it was amazing. I'm only playing in the middle, but he was so grateful. And so Rohit is really a plus for us. Also, he's as you say, he can play in each position we need, and I think he make difference between our country and other country all the time, or play in the middle or playing central back. He can do deliveries so well in both position. And I wish Kieran and Rohit can play more years together, because Nepal football needed these two players. I mean, without them, it's always a minus for the team.
Wow. So the time during the Three Nation football, so I was doing this tournament, knockout tournament, right? It was happening there. It was the semi-final and you guys were doing the press release for the Three Nations. So I had to, I watched the half and I ran away. So was the tournament a bit early for you? Because the time you had come in, the players were already leaving and some were still leaving the country. No, of course, yeah. This jersey was gifted to me by Pujan Uparkoti. Pujan. Yeah. So this was, I told you, I really like that player from a personal view. So I like the holding midfield and playmaking role players. So I told him to just sign his jersey and give it to me, but he got the sign of the whole team. And sadly, a lot of signatures in this jersey, these players have already left the country.
Yeah. I mean, this is so bad for Nepali football, but we need to respect them decision to go abroad, to go especially in Australia. But now they start to go to Japan, Canada. I mean, they start to move around. And I'm also happy that they give opportunity to make them family, to make them family happy, to be satisfied about them life. I believe that Nepal, we need to give more chance to this player to be here. No chances mean some opportunity, some belief, maybe the league more long. To keep the league, no, 3 months, but maybe...
Some gap between the games.
Yeah, gap between the games. Some more stability
yeah.
to be professionalism. And also more money involved because, I mean, get $1,000, $2,000 for 2-3 months and then don't work at all or make some tournament that you can get injured and you don't get paid anymore. It's make this player decides to go abroad. Is the truth that these guys, they go only for make more money and I cannot blame them because it's them decision. And I mean, you cannot expect that the player play all the time for glory because glory don't make your family happy. I mean, you need to have the right contribution of your effort for the country. So if the player give the heart, maybe give one ligament, to be professionalism at the maximum level for compete with another country, which is India, example, you need to give the right contribute to them. So it's painful that we lost so many players in this short and so many players for national team. But I love to be all the time positive and to see that in Nepal, we have a lot of talent, the young generation. We play with the many under 23. Yugalan, Dangi, Eric Bista even played 2-3 years, but he's already 23. I mean, many, we speak about Ananta and Anjan, but Ananta and Anjan, they have 25 years.
Yeah,
so
about that like, age.
It's not that great. They have a big future for Nepali football.
There's also one player coach. I think you might have heard of him. His name is Sansu Busal.
Mm-hmm.
He was in Sado Bato Youth Club last season.
Yeah.
But this time he's living in Qatar. Mm-hmm. So he plays for a club there. And I think he's not even 20, 19, 20, somewhere around there.
Yeah,
and I've seen the potential in that guy.
Yeah, I saw. But like I decided to select the player that I saw, you know, in reality. Honestly, even I mean Roy Chinese, because I know him personality before, I know well, and I don't like to call example other player that we don't know the status of performance, mm-hmm. physical performance status, if they play really professionally, if they do other stuff, because example in Australia, I think they can have a really strong team right now in Australia, mm-hmm. with the Nepal.
Yeah.
And but maybe many of the guys, they don't practice real sport. Mm. They say maybe they only focus on the job. So I decide to select only the player that play in A division plus, as I say, we call Royt and Kieran. That there are more near on the respective club, no? Call big talent abroad and maybe they don't feel in the player. I don't need. I also all the time think that one player don't make big difference. I think that the group will make difference.
So, it's always a team game.
Yeah. So I all the time believe in hard job and working with the player.
Coach, I never compare people, but I've seen a difference in as a Nepali fan, as someone who's really close to Nepali football through commentary. See, the time when Al Mutairi came in, he had Nepal Super League to select the players. So he had that advantage. I'm just being very neutral. So he had the privilege, advantage of selecting players from a 20-25 days tournament, right? So he got that advantage. From when you came in, now this is my comparing point. You saw there's a bit of a mess there. The players are leaving. And suddenly, yeah, after you come, you have to lead the team to the Three Nation Cups. How was the pressure there?
No, there was, I mean, pressure, never be pressure. I enjoy to be football coach. So pressure was adventure. And I select the best player that I saw to play. Right now this competition, SAFF competition, or in a friendly game in Philippines, I will change many players. Mm. Because maybe in the first, I was like 20 days for select. In these 20 days, some player that was impressing me, some player no. Mm. So right now it's totally many player of them. They will be inside the team, and many player they will be outside the team. Mm. So doesn't matter. I mean, many time, you know, also for Italian football, for England football, for Brazil football, depend about performance, individual performance. If one coach see that in short period, you deserve to be in national team, they will select the national team. I don't have any friend in Nepal football. I don't have any link with Nepal political side that all the time they support and want to share this in the media. And I don't have no one pressing from me, from no one, no president, no GS, say me one word about players. There are very professional in this. No one player, no one person nearby technical staff, no one pressure from no one. Mm. All player that I select by my eyes. Mm. If I make mistake, it's because of my quality of coaching skills is this. If I make good, I hope I make good, and I decide to select the player as best that I can. Many time in national team, the supporter, they need to understand that I select the player not because they are the best, but they are the best in base of my view, my tactical advising. Also, for me, it's important also behavior with media, behavior with the team, behavior with coach. I mean, I know that many stuff that maybe some person from abroad, just because we want to create confusion with EMFA, they start to blame the coach or start to blame. For me, they give a negative comment about coach. I mean, I'm sad, but I don't care so much. I have been like, now will be like 275 game now that there will be. It's I don't feel so much pressure in this. The supporter, they will always criticize. Honestly, what I don't understand about the Nepali supporter, that all the time they are against EMFA, all the time they are against what decision it will be over there. And maybe there will be again also me now, right now, that I speak about this. And if there are again them, okay, but all the time again, it's a bit boring to me. That's why I don't go in many interview. That's why I don't make myself available for a journalist. I am always positive, and I want all the time release something positive for the nation, for all support. And I don't want any scoop, any misunderstanding, any controversial word. Because I'm like this, I'm clear. So I don't have a double word, or I don't have a double face. I'm no near to the journalist. I don't like to share my info with the journalist. I have my private life. I don't share with them. So I would love to give one good impression for Nepali supporters. If they don't want this good impression, they can speak negative, it's no problem. But I would love to that they think that behind me there is a man that is a full on football, full 24 hour, I think, only for developing of football in Nepal. Only this.
Wow. You really speak your mind. I really like the way you're speaking, especially your voice tone. Yeah. The heaviness in your voice tone looks... It reminds me of a commentator called Arlo White. He does commentary in England and especially in the US. So yeah, he's said to be having the velvety voice. You know, there's this series called Ted Lasso. Did you see that?
Yeah, I hear about that for a short time. I can't see this this series, but I love to see with after this tournament. Maybe I will.
I'll share it to you.
Yeah,
it's on Apple TV.
On Apple
but
TV,
but I'll share
I
it
know,
to you. I have it.
It will be nice. It will be nice to
an
watch.
Account, so I'll share it to you. So it's fun, and apart from the voice, I want to now. So I see with you. You are for Nepal, you're already on the mission. And as Mikel Arteta says, trust the process. Am I right?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, the process we need to trust, and we need to trust about who is ahead of everything. You know, that is not me. And we need to put focus on the players. No focus. I know that, I'm sorry for repeat again, I know that all the time, you know, I have a lot supported from Italy. Mm-hmm. All the time they open some link for Nepali football. All the time there is some comment of negative size about football. And this is not make the country in a good way, honestly. It's not a good sponsorship for the country. I would love that to put more focus on positive sides than no negative sides. As I say, I make one short example, like MB, no, Nepali A Division League, Nepali Premier League, right now is they play each 2-3 days, is no right to play each 2-3 days. I can say one positive example about this, that you play 2-3 days, you play more game than before, mm-hmm. because I think before you doing only one game, no home away. So yeah. You can play more game. I think in totally game, how many game it would be? Like 200? Almost 200?
No, around 192, if
yeah,
I'm not
wrong.
Yeah,
almost 200.
192.
You know? So almost 200 game that make Nepali football to play a lot games. So in this, there is a lot improvement. And many journalists speak about, oh, the quality, this player, they go to Australia, they lost a lot of quality, but who know that there is something plus quality that the guys, they coming up, they can develop in the football more better than previous player. True. I mean, we need to think, and we need to say that in each can be negative thing, there is always positive thing. That's why I don't really like to watch the media or to be in link with the media footballer. I would love to that this mentality will change a bit. I know it's only word, they will nothing change maybe, or they will criticize also this to me. So I just want to share this in public because it's make me sad all the time. I see some new again ANFA, again some particular person in ANFA. Because this person, they try to do the maximum. If they cannot make it, for sure they try to do maximum. It's not to speak positive about them. I am not there because of them. Maybe they select me, but I say all the time the truth. If they do something wrong, I will speak also wrong about them. I'm like this. But president is always available in ANFA. And it's available to everybody want to go to speak with ANFA. GS is always there to do, to improve, to try to do improving the football. I don't know why all the time they attack them both. And maybe many reason about political size, but I don't know, and I don't want to know about this. Important is that Nepali football, after this tournament, there is a lot player that coming up, even young player. I'm so sad that we cannot participate of Futu Under 23 tournament. It's not one way that we need to reply about this, but there is some financial problem. Also, GS and President try to do everything for try to participate in this tournament. Well, we cannot. So what we do, we try to think about future. We don't think anymore about this. So now it's focus on first friendly game of Philippines, then focus on tournament SAFF in India.
SAFF happening against our arch rivals, India, who is the 8-time winner of SAFF, and in their home country. It's going to be difficult for Nepal. But coach, I was doing my analysis, and I thought like, okay, our coach has a good experience in India. So that might turn out to be some help for you to exploit the mistakes of the Indian players.
Yeah,
you can always see from the brighter side, right?
Yeah, well, in each competition is different. So for me, this is my first country in Asia to be a coach in the national team in Asia. So I can see that this competition is very high. Like you say, the winner, there are the India, and India host this competition. It will be very hard because also in this competition we have Kuwait, where is high football with international coach Beto, that is a great coach, is a winner coach. So, and plus Pakistan make a lot international player from abroad.
Yes, I heard about this player playing in the English division football.
Yeah.
He's been straightly taken into the team.
Yeah.
I think the same happened with the women's team, because last year, by this time maybe, Pakistan women's team was here for SAFF Women's Championship. So Nadia Khan played for, if I'm not wrong, Doncaster Rovers, which played in the third tier. So she was an amazing footballer. Now, looking at that, the male footballer is going to come. He's going to seriously challenge Nepal in there.
For sure. Each player that play from England football is the top of the top in Europe and in the world. I mean, England football, we know very well about marketing, about entertaining, about speedy of football. They are so powerful tactically. Now, all coach, international coach go there. And it will be a very big plus for Pakistan that we know that they are very physically. And I think the favorite is still India, because he host the tournament. Is normal is this, but Kuwait is a mass amazing skills players, plus a quality coach, and plus they have a ranking in them favor. As I say, I respect all team. There is also another Giron, there is a Lebanon that this time is in SAFF Championship, that it will be very hard to play versus them because of them background. And also other team, they work so hard. Bhutan, I hear this work after three national, they start to work out for this tournament. And we know that all team, they have them plus, them minus. And we hope that we respect everybody. We hope to performance at the same level of this country. This is what I want. No, many times they say, what is your target, coach? A big question. I say, my target is to be able to face them first. Because we lost a lot of international players. As we know, we don't have a great experience, but I believe in my player. I believe in Nepal player that they are careful. I believe that we can make a great impact in this tournament also.
So judging by your words, you have seen some level of potential in this Nepalese team,
Right? Sure. 100%. And I am a bit sad that I cannot work many time with them because of league competition. We cannot stop the league during this competition. So I will only have the team for the national team for short period. But in this short period, we need to do the maximum that we can. Other country, we know, like India is preparing 1 month and a half, almost 1 month for this tournament. They play in continental tournament. And also, for sure, I mean, we have Bhutan that after Three Nations, they start to train. We have a lot of country where they think about so much about this tournament. But we need to see that what we have, the time with the short time that we have, we need to try to make impact first in the first game versus Philippines. Then we think about other game.
Fatigue is going to be a very big challenge for you because the way these players are playing, they're playing, running like machines, playing game every 2 days in and out. And a lot of players are sustaining some minor to some concerning injuries. So that will be a challenge for you.
Yeah, for sure. I just have afraid about injury, honestly. About the physicality, I can see that many of players in this, because they play after short period, 2-3 years, I can see that many guys, the peak of performance is high. Many guys, the peak, they go down, then they go up. It's normal because many times they don't have a time to rest. My only concern is to hope to don't lose any important player. And even any player, because for me, each player is so important. For me, each player, I will call up 23 players. In this 23, all 23, they have a chance to play with me. Mm. So I don't look in Galas a big name. Of course, we know that some important name that are in the team. Mm. But we need to be aware that each player can play, and the important that will be the substitution. Because also in a SAFF Championship, we will play each 3 days. So there is no maybe there is also plus for this.
True. So have you been following the league? Have you, like, I see you go to games often.
Yeah.
But what do you do when you don't get to go to the ground? It's all the television that does the work.
I go in the ground in each game. If I'm not in the game, many times the telecast is. They permit myself to watch when I would be at home in YouTube. So right now also there is telecast of EMFA, so I try to watch over there. But many time I miss some game for sure. But what I need to know and what I need to watch, I have already make a decision for this tournament. I think now, right now, we have in the short period that everything is almost the size for relegation, for win the title. Mm-hmm. So we have a big surprise this year about relegation and title.
So I've heard, I've not been able to follow the league this season around because, one, I'm not involved. Plus, second, I'm very busy with my podcast because I do a lot of shoots in a week. So the editing is there. So production is difficult. So I heard, if tomorrow Church Boys wins against 3-star, they're going to lift the title.
Yeah.
It's amazing for a team that has just been promoted.
Yeah. I mean, Church Boys, that they have a quality player. So we know that Ananta and John, as I say, they are in this club. But also Choldery has done so well, especially in the last period. And Eric Pista in the last two games. I mean, I believe that the one of the important impact of this league, when he come back fit, was Anjan. Because Anjan make a very good difference for this. But all team, also the coach, the staff, the keeper, the foreigner keeper, so well. I think the second year, so third year, he's here in the country, in Nepal, you know. Cameroon's keeper, right?
Yeah,
so it's they have a very strong team in each report, in each also substitution that are good. And they done so well, and maybe they deserve to win the title. Machindra, after 2 years, that was also nearby to win the league. Unfortunately, this year, I think they were lost. I mean, they don't have any chance. But I'm sad also for Machindra because he have an amazing quality player. I mean, maybe he lost too many points in the beginning, Machindra. Yeah. No?
It was a slow start.
Slow start, I think, because of many reasons. They changed the coach. Chencho get injury. Chencho was the Bhutan striker, amazing superstar striker of Bhutan.
Yeah, so, Chencho Gelson.
So we I think Machindra also, maybe they can deserve to win the title if they start to performance from the beginning. Mm. But is the football is like this, and I'm sad for them. And but we have also fighting for relegation still going on. And let's see what can be happen in the next two game that will be for the league. Mm. I really wish good luck for all players. They have done so well. They have done so well, so much effort. All team, police team, APF, army team, three star, all team. They have done also all coach. They have done so well this intensity league. I think it was very stressful for them as a coach.
True.
Because you will be faced days by days preparing the game. Then after that, the day after, you don't know what to do. Maybe you give day rest or you go to tactical session. So it's not easy. I think
sometimes you also as a coach need rest, and so they're not getting that.
Yeah. I think they get great experience this year, also for the coach. They improve them in the better level. I believe this league improved them the high level. And as I say to you, I mean, I would love to see more foreigner coach. I would love to see more tactically assistant coach, physical coach for foreigner. Oh, maybe physical coach in Nepal only here. Maybe they can call from India. Why not? I mean, it would be nice to see some goalkeeper coach also. It would be also nice. Many club they don't have goalkeeper coach. It's painful. And match analysis coach, as you say before.
You know, coach, a few years ago, when I started doing football commentary, so I was in the commentary box for a television. I was the only commentator there. There was no... I didn't have a co-commentator. So I ask them if I can have someone who could at least give me numbers. The number of just corners each team is taking, the number of fouls they've committed, the number of offsides, the in-game stats. So they said no to me. So what I did was, whatever they were paying me, which is really, really less. So I asked one of my brothers, who is one of the most knowledgeable guy about Nepali football. He's Utsav Bajgai. You might know him, Utsav. So, so he came. So I actually paid him out of my pocket to do the stats thing. And since then, I tried to maintain that culture. And then me and my fellow commentators, we always emphasized on the point that we have to have a statsman sitting beside us, at least to know about the player that's being subbed, so we could tell in advance. And at least we could have those number of corners, the number of free kicks, the number of yellow cards and the stats. So it's very difficult in Nepal because I think the game of football is all about numbers. It's all about statistics, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I would love also to see some less many times, you know, by also can see by referee issue. In Nepal, they stop the game so much time. And maybe depend about referee, maybe depend about players. Many times the team that lead 1-0, they start to lose the time, they start to enter in the field, with the medical staff. So I would love to see also the minutes of the play. No, this analysis is also important. This in international game, when you play versus national team, you can see that the stopping there are very less comparing Nepal A Division League. This is can be one plus where maybe Football Federation can work on. I think also Nepali referee there are good enough to manage this. And I hope we can develop him also this kind of football. And we can see that the statistical, there are all the time know that we don't have a lot of knowledge on this. So we need the people like you that maybe they can help to register a number of each action. Possession ball in them half, not in our half. Many of them, how many counterattack, how many foul. This is important also. Mm-hmm. Or which foul we make in our half, which foul we make in them half. It's a plus. It's a plus to understand better the football. No, as each year we know that the football developing in the fast way. That's why I don't like to compare myself or the national team country as Nepal between other country, between other years before. So it's important to think about these years, important to make a good impact these years, important to make a good impact for the future.
Sure. Wonderfully said again. And also talking about the level of Nepali football, or the club culture. How do you see that? How do you compare? Let's not compare with the other countries, but in your opinion, how is Nepali domestic football?
As I say, Nepali football, they can be provided and be improved by international coaching. I believe, even myself, if you have some conversation with Nepali staff in each team, that many times I don't have possibility to speak with them, I can improve them also, and I'm available to improve this. But as I try to be near to them, many times maybe they think there are, I don't say jealous, because no one is jealous about Nati, but they try to keep distance between me, and it's okay for me. But I think Nepal football needs a bit advice. Advice for international coach for many aspects about they can be also increase of supporters. I noted and many person they say to me, oh, we lost a lot of supporters before, there was more supporting in the field, in the stadium. Right now there is not too many supporters, but I think there is a lot of support for the number of the game that we have. So let's see. I mean, we need to improve a bit the sport culture that can be under ourselves. No, many times I saw we take a discussion with referee, where I don't like at all discussion with referee. Mm-hmm. Maybe I can get 1 minute or 30 second discussion of referee, and then I focus on my game. But I saw many club, they speak with referee like 90 minutes. They are ready to see some mistake and to try to find some mistake to speak with referee strong, to say, why you don't whistle this foul, or why don't whistle penalty, no? All people can mistake, and we are not perfect. I will make mistake for sure in the SAFF Championship. I will make mistake in the international friendly game, but I am human being. Everybody can make mistake. The player miss penalty, the player miss the goal, the player miss make foul for the opponent. Everybody make mistake, and also referee can make mistake. So it's a good plus for teach them the value of sport in general, not only the value of football. And it can be a great improvement for Nepali football, this. I think like more discussion, more communication, proper communication. also with the player. The player, they must have a more fair play. I would love to have a more fair play from the player. And I think they will go forward.
Yeah. You just said something and reminded me, like, since we're on the topic of everyone makes mistakes. So I realized the 1994 World Cup, Baggio missing the penalty for your contest. Sorry, that was Italy, but I've watched it all when I was a kid. I've watched it since then on ESPN. And as I said, Italy is one of my favorite countries.
Yeah.
Though I'm always Argentina, Albiceleste. So I fell in love with players like Totti and Vieira.
Yeah.
So those were the players at that time. Maldini was something of a different breed. They don't make someone like him now, right? So you always make mistakes, like from the game. A player making a mistake, should have crossed, he shot the ball. A coach, he should have maybe subbed someone, he subbed the other player, a defender instead of a goalkeeper, sorry, a midfielder, let's say. And a commentator misspelling a name of a player. That always happens in life or a game of football.
Yes, yes. I mean, you remind me of this penalty versus Brazil that cost us the tournament. I mean, I would love to think that Roberto Baggio, he missed rarely the penalty, but he's poor talent and a great person, really amazing person.
And he was the one who took Italy all the way to the final in that tournament.
I mean, he's an amazing talent player. He was an amazing talent player. And I think that all people can make a mistake, but you need to try to do the maximum that you can. I mean, when I will finish this tournament, I am with my conscience through 100% that I give all my maximum that I can. I cannot give more than 1 millisecond time of Nepali football. I mean, I'm here not so much about money, not so much. I don't focus on this. I'm only focused about to try to win something with Nepal, try to develop football in Nepal. I try to give one advice for the future, because maybe next year can be another coach. I will be always grateful if they have a good memory about Coach Annese.
Absolutely. And it again reminded me of the 2006 World Cup final.
Yeah.
So this one player for me, Coach, was the architect of the whole match. Materazzi, not just the headbutt. The first goal France scored was because of his foul. The other goal, I think it was him scoring or it was an assist, the equalizing goal.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then comes the headbutt. And also, I think he scored the winning penalty in that final, right?
You imagine that Materazzi was no there from the first 11.
Yeah.
So it was because of injury. He entered and make a big impact. I mean, Materazzi is an amazing player. Before we was, as you say before, I mean, we was with a strong central back, Cannavaro, Materazzi, Nesta, Maldini. Yeah. I mean, in foreign country, we have so much great central back. And Materazzi make a huge impact, especially in the semi-final, final. I mean, that they make this difference between the two teams. I think that everybody know the offer of all team of Italy in 2006. It's not only about one player.
True. And, I completely agree with you.
I think and I hope that this can be repeated, because right now we don't qualify 2 times in World Cup.
And that's strange as well, right?
It's very strange. I mean, because we win Europa with Mancini and then we lost. So I hope next World Cup we can participate in. About some strange group stage, we have some bad impact because we have also league to play. So we are no focus on some game and then we rush for the others, the pressure come up. I mean, it was something like this about qualification round for World Cup. But I hope that Italy must be back to World Cup 100%.
Yeah, Italy is football heritage.
Yeah, no, for sure. I mean, in Italy, all the time, we are like how many million? 62 million. All the time, there are 62 million coach. I mean, it's like I hear about about this in one interview about Briton coach, head coach De Zerbi, and it's like he say that all the time the Italian people that are coach. No, if I invite my sister here in this program, they can speak more about tactical session than some people. Really, there are from child room, we everybody speak about football. We play outside the school, outside. Here is sad that I don't see no one play outside. I would love to see more player play football. I don't see better than cricket, no, but maybe at the same level than cricket.
True.
It can be better. Because football is like everybody will love more football. It would be nice for Nepal.
Also, Zlatan Ibrahimovic retired today.
Yeah, I saw the news. So sad. So sad for football at all. Not for Italy, I mean, because he was linked with Milan, but so sad for the football. He was an inspiration play man of many years.
41 years of life, he's playing for a team like AC Milan.
No, it's amazing. It's amazing talent. I mean, he never been in the first three World Ballon d'Or. Hmm. But he's
always there,
almost top there, five. Like, yeah, yeah. But I mean, his talent. I mean, no one can be like him. Him character, him spirit, or him personality. He's a winner. I mean, Milan. I think Pioli, that is the coach of Milan, he get a good plus when he come in the Milan, because many times maybe he don't deserve to play because he's out of him fiscal range, but is there to reach a great point with the personality inside the dressing room, the speaker before, after game, in the training. He was a fighter. No one can lose. The ball was to him. If something happened during the training, I'm so happy to be part of Italy, where he was one historical player for Italian football. For Milan, Juventus, Inter, I mean,
Barcelona.
He played in this United. and he played versus Paris, in Paris, in Barcelona. I mean, he played in even USA. He make big difference when he go there. I mean, he's amazing. He's amazing. So sad for football in general, but his life is like this. I think whatever now he will choose to do it, it will make difference. Also, if he can become actor, it will make difference over there. If one person isn't special, it's special everywhere.
True. This United legend has played in a lot of movies. Sto naam birsake maile. Dai, United ko tyo ki kanne ke? Eric Cantona.
Oh,
he's played in a few movies.
Yeah. Well, Cantona, it's another crazy guy. Eh? I mean, Cantona also, I have a great memory of him. He was a very good striker also. I mean, it's one of symbol of England football, and he's legend player. So as Ibrahimovic was and he is. I mean, there are amazing player work and all the time be unforgettable for football fans.
Yes. And talking about Cantona especially, you once mentioned that Sir Alex Ferguson had a big role in making him a better player because his attitude, and a lot of times we see a player has the talent but needs some kind of direction. And yeah, he says, like, Sir Alex Ferguson showed him the way. So
yeah,
that's the importance of a coach, right?
Yeah, on and
off the field.
I hear your interview with your volleyball national team coach of Nepal. It was amazing when he say that the coach is one person where everybody get a referring point of him. Everybody must be like a model for them. And as me also, I don't smoke, I don't drink. I mean, I only focus on sport. Even in my Sometimes I have some limitation to do sport right now, but I go each day in the gym or swimming pool. I be careful what I eat. I want to be fit always. And I think this mentality will carry on for all my life. Even I'm 38, but it will be like discipline is so important for the coach to give example for the player. And I believe that a strong personality coach, they can make the player better. True. In each aspect, about life aspect, about winning mentality. Don't lose the ball. I mean, don't lose the life ball. Like some advice, when you are a winner in each discipline, not only in the football. This can be in a personal life with your wife, with everybody, with each business you do.
Absolutely true. So, coach, we've come to the end. Towards the end, we can actually carry on for the whole night. No problem. People will listen. I know because I told you I have been getting so many messages from your fans that we need the coach because I don't think they've seen you given a proper interview properly because since the time you came, you've been busy. Now you're looking, trying to sort out the players. The tournament is already coming up and you don't have time with
the
players
again. I
don't
like so much get the interview, but I accept from you because, I mean, I like the way that you approach on me and I'm so happy to be here.
Thank you, coach.
Under your interview. I mean, my supporter, I would love to be more near with me. I don't have too much time to spend with them. I see that there are a lot in this. They come in the stadium. I enjoy them attitude. Nepal people that are so nice. I love them. I mean, it's a part of really football all the time. There are very good education and very good culture here. They call us a guru. So they give us a lot of respect. I think working in Nepal till now, it was very, very pleasure to work here. And I expecting more and more support from them. I need more support from them. Yeah.
You know, personally, I want to call you the Al Pacino of Nepali football.
No, it's a great.
It's a compliment, coach.
Yeah. No, it's. I hope that we can achieve some good stuff for future. And as I say many times that here in also in Asia and well also in Italy in Europe, we see so much about who win, who lost. If you win, you're a good coach. If you lost, you're no, it's about what you leave to the country, what you leave to individual players, and which level they start and which level you make them. So I hope to make them better and better. And I hope also to give a good contribution for Nepali football.
Wow. Let's end this session on a very high note. So the question I want to ask you is not putting pressure on you, I'm speaking as a Nepali football supporter.
Yeah.
Right? So, keeping all other things constant, where can we see Nepal in the SAFF Championship? What's your aim?
Watch, I almost answered to you before, but I try to explain better. Important for us is to be competitive. I mean, I want to be really competitive versus Kuwait, to be very competitive versus Philippines. India also, I mean, they are so strong country. Believe me, they are strong. I saw them, I know them. I know ISL level, how is it? I know Nepal, A division level, how is it? Yeah. So we know very well that they are strong. So we need to fight versus them. And I want that we are the same level. I don't want to see different between them. My only concerns can be about the physicality, but there is no excuse in the football. they will adjudicate myself, my service at maximum level that they can. All the time they will say, and they will adjudicate the player of Nepali always. So I wish that we can offer the same level of football. I don't think Nepal have a good memory score line versus Kuwait, if I'm not mistake. So
not a good record.
I will love to be competitive versus them, because it's our first game of SAFF. Mm. And then game by game, then we have India, then we have Pakistan. So important is the first approach versus Philippine international game. Then we have another game, another game, another game. We take game by game, and we hope to be at the level that we deserve to be.
Almost 1.5 hours that I promised, it's going to be over in 1 hour.
No problem.
I want to ask so many more, but I think let's keep it for some other sessions.
Yeah,
when you guys come back with a trophy, you will have the trophy right here.
It will be my pleasure to be here with the trophy. It will be my pleasure to be back here.
Yeah, we'll love to invite you. I always love to invite you. So let's end it on a good note, Coach. Thank you so much for coming. I know you're a busy guy. You're looking after players. You have to short out. There are a lot of problems there. But once again, thank you.
Thank you so much for your cast here. Nice people, amazing person around here. And it was my pleasure to show my view a bit of Nepali football. I hope nobody get offended after my word. And if I do something, I do only for the good, positive way in the football. As I say before, I don't link with no one political side, so friend of friend. I don't have so much friends. I don't believe in this. I believe only in myself and what I can achieve with the football. So I wish I can do the best for Nepal.
Thank you so much, Coach, and all the very best for SAFF Championship.
Thank you so much.